There has been much debate about how many persons have been killed in the war on drugs during the last administration. Some of the estimates have been as low as 12,000, while the NGOs have put the figure at about 30,000. But there is one number that is unassailable because this comes from the Office of the President and was cited in an extended resolution of the Supreme Court. And that number is 20,322 persons killed in the war on drugs.
Who is the president you're referring to?
The former president, Rodrigo Roa Duterte, Your Honor. That number of 20,322 persons killed is only from the period of July 1, 2016 up to November 27, 2017. This is found in the 2017 year-end accomplishment report of the Office of the President and cited in the resolution of the Supreme Court of April 3, 2018. Hindi lang po yon. In the of the 20,322 who were killed, according to the OP report, 3,967 Filipinos were killed by police in police operations during the period from July 1, 2016 to November 27, 2017.
Ano po? 3,000?
3,967.
Between what year?
July 1, 2016, Mr. Chair, up to November 27, 2017.
So ano po yung 6,000 na sinasabi na dito?
I do not know where that figure comes from, Your Honor. Then there is another figure, 16,355 killed by riding in tandem and other unknown persons during the same period from July 1, 2016, this time until September 27, 2017.
Okay, ilan po yun?
16,355, Mr. Chair.
Are these people killed?
Yes, Your Honor.
From what date?
From July 1, 2016 up to September 27, 2017. I have a copy, Your Honor, of the resolution of the court. I can submit it to the committee secretary. Now, I would like to emphasize, Your Honor, please, that the 20,322 who were killed were not sentenced by any judge of our country. They were sentenced.
Who are these 3,000 that were killed? Kasama ba ito 16,000?
Yung 3,967, Mr. Chair, yan yung napatay during police operations according to the Office of the President's report. Yung naman pong 16,355 refer to deaths under investigation. These are referring to those who were killed by riding in tandem and other unknown killers.
Not necessarily police operations.
Now, all of these 20,322 persons who were killed were not sentenced by any court. They were sentenced by armed men, 3,967 of them belonging to the Philippine National Police, and another 16,355 by unknown people, who many of whom continue to roam our country today.
No investigation that had been done by the Philippine National Police.
Sa pagkaalam ko po, of the 16,355 killed by riding in tandem and other similar killers, only two men were caught, arrested, and charged. But when nung po sila hinuli, napag-alaman na police din pala sila.
Saan niyo po nakuha yung data?
That is data available in the news. This refers, Your Honor, to the killing of a crime watch person in Mindoro, if I remember right, around 2016 or 2017. It so happened na nung binaril siya ng dalawang riding in tandem, dalawang taon nasa isang motorsiklo, inabol sila ng police at nahuli, pero na pag-alaman nga na sila rin pala ay police. Now, I would like to emphasize, if Your Honor, please, that all of these people who were killed, that would fill up the SM Mall of Asia Arena. And that is only for the period of 2016 July up to 2017 November. Now, they were not sentenced by a court. They were sentenced by armed men. And up to now, as we know from the testimony of the DOJ Secretary during the last hearing of this Honorable Committee, there have only been 52 cases that they have investigated out of 20,322 deaths. And that is why we are concerned. I'm speaking here on behalf of the Free Legal Assistance Group, which I chair, one of the oldest and largest human rights organizations in the country, that there has been no accountability insofar as the war on drugs is concerned.
Attorney Diokno, let me make it clear, Noah. I mean, you are a member of a political party, correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Now, I will never question your expertise in law, but I would like to question your motivation on this. Is there any politics in this?
No, Your Honor. I am appearing here in someone's because I was summoned by the Honorable Committee to appear.
Gusto ko lang po put on record na there's no politics involved in this.
Yes, Your Honor. The data I am mentioning were part of a extended resolution of the Supreme Court in a case that questioned the entire war on drugs. Kasi po, pag pinag-aralan natin yung war on drugs, yan ay nagsimula sa isang Command Memorandum Circular 16-2016 na pinirmahan ni then PNP Chief Rolando Bato de la Rosa on his first day as the Chief of the PNP. This Command Memorandum Circular is what authorized what they call double barrel, yung pong tokhang and targeting the high value targets, then which then became operationalized as what we know as the war on drugs.